The Ark was buried under the Temple of Solomon in an underground tunnel and thought lost forever, until now. The most important evidence that the Bible is totally true could come from the rediscovery of the Ark of the Covenant. That's why so many have looked so hard for it. But does the Ark really exist? Did it ever exist? In 1981, an excavation took place on Temple Mount, in which three rabbis made a discovery that nearly set off another holy war between the Muslims and Jews.
If we look at this sketch of the Temple Mount in Jerusalem, we can see subterranean passageways superimposing upon this a model of the temple. The Jewish historical sources tell us that there was a chamber of wood, or a wood pen, underneath which was a secret chamber that King Josiah deposited the Ark of the Covenant in shortly before the destruction of the temple by the Babylonians. In 1981, three rabbis entered through Warren's Gate, one of the original entrances to the Temple Mount. They tunneled through and came to an area in which they claim they now have direct knowledge of the exact location of the Ark of the Covenant.
Do you believe that some of the temple treasuries...
Yehuda Getz, chief rabbi of the Western Wall, was one of the tunnelers in 1981. Rabbi Getz states that he has found the Ark of the Covenant and its contents, including the tablets containing the original Ten Commandments, hidden for over 2,500 years in the secret vault beneath the temple. These incredible discoveries were also witnessed by Rabbi Shlomo Goren.
We were excavating under the Temple Mount in Jerusalem when we came to an underground room in the direction of the Holy of the Holies. And it was the Ark of the Covenant that Moses placed the Ten Commandments in. But when we came close to the Holy of the Holies, the Arab management of the Temple Mount decided to stop our diggings, and they erected a wall in order to stop us from getting to the Holy Ark.
As to the contention that the Ark under the Temple Mount is a replica, the same contention might as easily be made concerning the Ethiopian Ark. There is really no other basis to support the Ethiopian claim than the Ethiopian traditions. And in fact, there are a great many replicas of the Ark throughout the churches in Ethiopia that preserve this tradition. The evidence rather strongly supports the real Ark being under the Temple Mount.
One of the most exciting events on the horizon today is the emergence of a temple being rebuilt in Jerusalem. This is the third of three major events in Israel: the reestablishment of the nation Israel, the regaining of biblical Jerusalem by Israel, which happened in 1967, and now they are preparing to build the temple. This whole event is all tangled up with their messianic expectation, and to a biblical scholar, it's one of the most exciting things on our horizon.
There's over 100 different passages in the Bible that talk about a future temple. We know that Israel's getting ready to build such a temple. There's over 500 priests that are now in training in the ancient Levitical sacrifice system. We know that millions of dollars has been set aside. Even the government has been involved in studies of how to rebuild the temple. But what about the Ark? When I asked only 4 or 5 months ago the chief rabbi's representatives, together with other rabbis in Israel, about the Ark, they told me that the Ark is now in Israel. They tell me that the Ark will be in the next temple.
The key to our direct relationship with God is the Holy Temple. And the main way that we are going about this is by actually producing, restoring, creating the vessels that can be used in the temple. Of the 93 basic categories of vessels that are described in the holy sources, we have so far created almost 60 vessels made of gold, copper, and silver, according to the original source material and based on the complicated nuances and requirements of Jewish law. While our itinerary includes many of the vessels that are described in the holy sources to be used in the temple, the Ark is one item which is not on our itinerary for recreation, because we are aware of the location of the original, which was hidden in the time of the first temple before the first destruction.
The evidence is very strong. The Ark of the Covenant has been found under this mount. We can only hope that someday in our lifetime, the ban by the Muslims will be lifted so that the Ark and its contents can be revealed to a waiting world. What will it be like if and when the Ark is recovered? What will be found inside when it is opened? Who will be selected to reach inside and withdraw the tablets of stone the Bible says God wrote upon? The idea is almost too stunning to ponder. And how will what is found inside change each and every one of us?